Diversity Challenge. Asking the questions, Jeremy Paxman.
Hello, the 2020-2021 University Challenge starts tonight. Around 130 student teams sat our test paper back in January. 28 of them did well on it and must try to do well again over the coming months. But this time under the scrutiny of millions of viewers, eager to be impressed and, need I say, reassured by the depth, the breadth and the sheer pellucid fecundity of their learning. As ever, the prize they're chasing is nothing more than to have their team name engraved on the winner's trophy and the undying glory of being champions. As ever, whichever team wins tonight goes through to the second round. If the losers can manage to be among the four highest-scoring losing teams from this stage of the competition, they'll get one last chance to qualify. Now, the University of Glasgow is one of Scotland's four ancient universities, founded in 1451 by a papal bull issued by Nicholas V. Its most famous alumnus is, alas, fictional. Doctor Who is supposed to be one of its graduates. But back in the real world, the economist Adam Smith studied there, as did the anthropologist James Fraser, the politicians Nicola Sturgeon and Vince Cable, and the actor Gerard Butler, with an average age of 26 and representing around 28,000 students. Let's meet the Glasgow team.
Hi, I'm Brian Nieves. I'm originally from Stevensville, Maryland, and I'm studying for a master's in history.
Hi, I'm James Warburton. I'm originally from Stelmine in Lancashire, and I'm studying for a PhD in the history of medicine.
And this is their captain.
Hi, I'm Rory McDyle. I'm originally from Belfast, Northern Ireland, and I'm studying for an MSc in Global Security.
Hello, I'm Michael Greencorn from Port Hawkesbury, Nova Scotia. I'm studying for a PhD in engineering.
Now, the University of Exeter received its Royal Charter in 1955. It's now spread over several campuses in Devon and Cornwall, and it has a particular reputation in Arabic and Islamic studies. Alumni include the writers Robert Bolt, John O'Farrell and J.K. Rowling, the singer Will Young, and the naturalist and broadcaster Steve Backshall, representing around 24,000 students with an average age of 20. Let's meet the Exeter team.
Hi, I'm Edward Parker. I'm from Braintree in Essex, and I'm studying archaeology and anthropology.
Hi, I'm Alfie Ryden. I'm from Brixham in Devon, and I'm studying mechanical engineering.
This is their captain.
Hi, I'm Cleo Gravett. I'm from Faversham in Kent, and I'm studying English.
Hello, I'm Matthew Williams. I'm from Bromley in Kent, and I'm studying physics.
The rules are the same as ever. 10 points for starter questions. You have to answer those on the buzzer by yourselves. 15 points for bonuses. They're team efforts. If you interrupt a starter question incorrectly, you'll lose 5 points. Fingers on the buzzers, please. What fruit links an opera by Prokofiev first performed in 1921?
Glasgow Nieves.
Sorry, oranges?
Oranges is correct, yes. Three questions on an architectural style for your first set of bonuses, Glasgow. Its name referring to the extensive use of raw concrete. What style is defined by rough, unfinished surfaces, unusual shapes, and small windows placed in massive walls?
Brutalism.
Brutalism is correct. The universities of East Anglia and Leicester include buildings by which architect? A leading exponent of brutalism, also noted for the buildings of the Royal National Theatre.
Anyone know any brutalist architects?
I mean, you want to pick an architect and go there?
Something tells me it's not Wren.
I don't know.
No idea.
No, we don't know.
It's Sir Denis Lasdon. And lastly, another notable example of brutalism, which estate in the City of London takes its name from a Roman watchtower that formerly occupied the site.
Roman watchtower. Do we even know a name for like something like that? Something. I mean, Chester's like a fort, so it's not going to be something, anything like that. Nah. Chester.
No, it's the Barbican. 10 points for this. Since the early 16th century, all male monarchs of which country have borne the regnal names Frederick or Christian? Christian II was the last also to rule over Sweden, while Frederick VI was the
Glasgow
last...
Glasgow Nieves.
Norway.
No, I'm afraid you lose 5 points. Frederick VI was the last to rule over Norway.
Exeter Parker.
Denmark.
Denmark by process of elimination. Well done. Three questions on the year 1963 for your bonuses, Exeter. In 1963, which US journalist published A Bunny's Tale? an exposé of practices at the Playboy Club. She went on to co-found Ms. Magazine and the National Women's Political Caucus.
Gloria Steinem?
Correct. The same year saw the publication of which best-selling non-fiction book by Betty Friedan? It's addressed to what she called the problem that has no name, the quiet desperation of the suburban housewife.
The Feminine Mystique?
Correct. And finally, I began to think maybe it was true that when you were married and had children, you were brainwashed, and afterwards you went about numb. In which novel of 1963 do those words appear?
The bell jar might be around then.
That's what I was thinking. Yeah, I don't know if she died around then. Yeah, the bell jar?
It was before she died. Well done, yes. 10 points for this. Quote, Berlioz tells it like it is. You take a trip, you end up screaming at your own funeral. These words of Leonard Bernstein refer to which work thought to be have been composed in part under the influence...
Exeter Williams.
Harold in Italy.
No, you lose 5 points. Thought to have been composed in part under the influence of opium and first performed in 1830.
Glasgow MacDowell.
This is La Symphonie Fantastique.
Correct. So you get a set of bonuses on pseudonyms in the sciences. From the 1790s, which mathematician used the pseudonym Monsieur Leblanc to submit papers to Lagrange and to correspond with Gauss?
Bernoulli, is that sort of time?
Ooh, I think he...
Too bit later? Or
he's a bit earlier than that.
Early, Euler or somebody? Euler?
Like, I mean, Swiss? Or someone like that. I don't know.
No, he's later as well, surely. I don't know. What do we want?
Pick your favourite.
Bernoulli.
No, it's Sophie Germain.
Okay.
From 1907, the statistician William Seeley Gossett published under what pseudonym inventing the T-test for quality control at the Guinness Brewery where he worked?
I think it's something about just a student. I think it
was just a student. Like the student or whatever,
yeah,
do you think?
It's called student's test.
Okay. So. Student? The student?
Correct. Which 18th century figure's pseudonyms included Celia Shortface, Martha Careful, Alice Addertongue, Silence Do-Good and Miss Busybody?
Franklin. Oh, yeah, yeah. Benjamin Franklin.
Correct. Right, we're going to take a picture round now. For your picture starter, you'll see a description in Spanish of the flag of a country where Spanish is an official language. For 10 points, give me the country's name.
Exeter Gravett.
The Philippines.
Anyone like to buzz from Glasgow?
Glasgow Nieves.
Is this Colombia?
It is Colombia. We'll see the whole flag. There it is. Well done. So, following on from the flag of Colombia, for your picture bonuses, three more descriptions in Spanish of the flags of countries with Spanish as an official language. 5 points for each country you can work out. Firstly...
blue star...
Are we thinking Panama, then?
Oh, could be.
Oh, is there... Yeah. Does it say two stars?
Yeah, I think it might be Panama.
Cinco Puntas, five-pointed red star.
Yeah, because that's... Right, yeah. Do you want to go Panama?
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 Panama is correct. There's the whole flag. Secondly...
So it's three stripes, same size. So blue is on the top and bottom.
Is it white Argentina? Bottom. It's five stars.
Yeah.
So are we thinking maybe Honduras?
Oh, it could be Honduras. Yeah, I think it could be Honduras.
Because
yeah.
It's what? Because it's three lines and five. Yeah. Yeah. Honduras?
It is Honduras, yes. And finally.
So nine stripes, same height.
Nine?
Yeah,
okay.
Could be like, I don't know, Equatorial Guinea or something like that. I don't know.
No, no. Because it's the one Spanish African one.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Oh, that could be a good shot.
Yeah, one sol, one sun.
Well, yeah, it's not saying the sun there.
Sun,
yeah.
Golden sun.
I mean,
I've got nothing better.
Yeah.
Did you say about Equatorial Guinea? Equatorial Guinea?
No, it's Uruguay. Let's see the whole thing.
Yes.
Right, another starter question. Quote, in fact, the trees are murmuring under your feet. A buried empathy, you tread it. These words appear in a poem by Carol Ann Duffy, marking the centenary of which non-ministerial government department founded in 1919 to restore the nation's woodlands after the First World War?
Glasgow MacDowell.
National Trust.
No, you lose 5 points. Anyone like to buzz from Exeter?
Exeter Parker.
The Forestry Commission.
That's correct. Right, these bonuses are on a shared name, Exeter. What is the English name of the waterfall known to the Pemon people of Venezuela by a name meaning waterfall to the deepest place?
Angel Falls.
Correct. Angel Clare, the son of a clergyman, marries which ill-fated heroine of a novel of 1891?
Yeah. Tess of the D'Urbervilles.
Correct. Dr. Angelicus is a byname of which 13th century scholastic philosopher, the author of the Summa Theologiae?
Yeah, definitely Aquinas.
Aquinas.
Aquinas is correct. 10 points for this. Level pegging. In which African country is the Apollo 11 cave, named by an archaeologist in 1969, on hearing of the mission's return to Earth, containing paintings at least 25,000 years old, it lies in an arid area at the juncture of the Great Fish and the Orange Rivers, a little north of its...
Exeter Parker.
South Africa.
You lose 5 points. A little north of its country's border with South Africa.
Glasgow Nieves.
Zimbabwe.
No, it's Namibia. 10 points for this. What two initials link the US goalkeeper in the 2015 FIFA Women's World Cup, the first British citizen to go into space?
Glasgow McDowell.
HS.
HS is correct. Well done. Your bonuses are on fictional companies. In each case, name the series of video games in which the following first appeared. Firstly, the Vault Tech Industries, a defense corporation contracted by the US government to produce a network of bunkers to protect citizens in the event of a nuclear holocaust.
It's Fallout.
Correct. The Umbrella Corporation, secondly, a pharmaceutical conglomerate founded as a front for research into eugenics and bioweapons. Symptoms of its T-virus resemble traditional depictions of zombies.
Resident Evil.
Correct. Abstergo Industries, finally, a tech multinational that is a front for the modern-day activities of the Order of the Knights Templar.
Yeah. Assassin's Creed.
Dear, oh dear, you embarrassment. Right, 10 points for this. In physics, what three-word term is used for the property of a rotating body given by the sum of the masses of each particle of the body multiplied by the squares of their perpendicular distances from the axis of rotation?
Glasgow Greencorn.
The mass moment of inertia?
Yes, I'll accept that. Yes, the moment of inertia usually known. Right, you get a set of bonuses on physics. What general name is given to scattering processes where both kinetic energy and momentum are conserved?
Elastic.
Correct. Born in 1842, which English physicist gives his name to a former scattering of electromagnetic radiation? He later discovered argon.
Yes, that's Rayleigh.
Correct. The name of which Indian physicist is applied to inelastic scattering of a photon off a charged particle?
It's Raman.
Raman.
Venkata Raman is correct. 10 points for this. James, an ex-actor, his morphine-addicted wife, Mary, and their two sons, Jamie and Edmund, are characters in which four-act drama? Published posthumously in 1956, the play takes place over one summer day in Connecticut.
Glasgow Nieves.
Is this Long Day's Journey into Night?
It is, yes. Your bonuses are on the novels of Charles Dickens. In each case, name the novel in which the following locations appear. Firstly, the Blue Dragon Alehouse, Mrs. Todger's commercial boarding house, the packet ship The Screw, and the Eden Settlement.
I don't know. Do you want to say David Copperfield?
I don't think it is.
I don't know.
I don't know. David Copperfield.
No, it's Martin Chuzzlewit. Okay. Secondly, the Maypole Inn, the Boot Tavern, a locksmith's shop called the Golden Key, and Newgate Prison.
I mean, do you want to just hedge your bets and keep saying David Copperfield? Because I honestly have no idea.
I don't know.
David Copperfield.
No, that's Barnaby Rudge.
It's next time.
I don't think this tactic's going to bear fruit. You know. And lastly, Bleeding Heart Yard, the Circumlocution Office, Venice and the Marshalsea.
Right. Does anyone recognise any of them?
No, I don't.
So we will feel really silly if we don't say David Copperfield in it.
It's not going to be. But go for it.
David Copperfield.
No, it's Little Dorrit. Everybody knows that. Right, we're going to take a starter question now on a music round. For your music starter, you'll hear a piece of popular music. 10 points if you can name the band performing. Make me a deal and make it straight. Or sign and seal a ticket to rub it in the address. I hope you don't know it goes. Exeter Gravett.
Roxy Music.
It is Roxy Music, yes. That was Virginia Plain, although you don't hear that until the final words of the song. Your music bonuses are three more well-known songs whose titles appear in the lyrics only once And as the final words, again, I just want the name of the band, please. Firstly, this band.
Squeeze.
It is Squeeze, yes, up the junction. Secondly, this band. Show me, show me, show me how you do that trick. The woman makes me scream, she said. The woman makes me laugh, she said. Threw her arms around my...
The Cure.
It is The Cure, it's Just Like Heaven. And finally, this band. Sometimes I fantasize
when the streets are cold. The Clash?
No, that's the Stone Roses, made of stone. Right, 10 points for this. Meaning mirror, what name links the film producer, whose credits include The African Queen and On the Waterfront, with a weekly news magazine based in Hamburg?
Glasgow McDowell.
Spiegel?
Spiegel is correct, yes. Right, your bonuses are on an Asian country. Which country was known as Funan and Chenla between the 1st and 8th centuries CE? It includes Tonle Sap, the largest freshwater body in Southeast Asia.
Funan. Are they, yeah, are these like sort of like Japanese kingdoms, do you reckon?
Well, Southeast Asia, he said.
Oh, Southeast Asia, yeah, so that...
I think like Thailand.
Yeah, maybe somewhere like Indochina or something. Like Thailand, do you reckon? Do you want to go to Thailand?
I've got no idea.
Thailand?
No, it's Cambodia. A treaty in 1863 gave which country control over Cambodia's foreign affairs, thus weakening the hegemony of Thailand and Vietnam?
I was going to say France, but that doesn't...
France is active in the area.
Yeah, but hold on, because if Vietnam's still active, surely it couldn't be France.
Could be the Dutch.
Unless it's gonna,
I don't know.
Unless it's just like China.
I mean,
it might just be China.
Yeah.
I'm just going to go China. China?
No, it was France. Oh, it was the right. Treaty of Wei. And finally, one of the world's longest-serving heads of government. Who became Cambodia's prime minister in 1985?
Is that just Pol Pot?
I was going to say, is that? No, that's after.
No, yeah. But Pol Pot died in 79.
Oh, okay.
So,
I don't know.
Does anyone know any Cambodian statesmen?
I
don't.
I know one Cambodian.
Well, other than that, no, I'm afraid we don't know.
That's Hun Sen. 10 points for this. Eunice Gardner, Monica Douglas and Sandy Stranger are characters in which 1961 novel, the title figure of which teaches at the Marcia Blaine School for Girls?
Exeter Gravett.
The Prime of Miss Jean Brodie.
Correct. These bonuses are on Britain at the Winter Olympics. Firstly, who became the first British athlete to win an Olympic medal in a snow event when she finished third in the inaugural slopestyle at Sochi in 2014?
Lizzie Arnold?
No, it wasn't. It was Jenny Jones. Yeah, adding a gold medal in 1952 to the bronze she had won 4 years earlier, Jeanette Altweg competed in which sport?
Is that like ski jump?
I was going to say it's ice skating, but it's ski jump.
I think it might be ice skating. Go ice skating.
Ice skating.
Correct. And in Pyeongchang in 2018, which woman created history by becoming the first Briton to succeed in defending a Winter Olympics title, doing so in the skeleton?
I think that's Lizzie.
Lizzie Arnold?
That is Lizzie Arnold, yes. 10 points for this. Also known as a spinode, what four-letter name is given to a singular point on a curve at which there are two different tangents that coincide?
Glasgow Greencorn.
Inflection point.
No, anyone want to bus from Exeter?
Exeter Ryden.
Node.
No, it's a cusp. 10 points for this. What was the surname of the artist brothers John and Paul, whose works include Dead Sea, Over the Top and Battle of Britain? The older brother, Paul, served as official
Exeter
war
Ryden. Artist.
Nash.
Nash is correct, yes. You get 3 questions on counties of the Republic of Ireland. 2 neighbouring counties on Ireland's west coast have names that end in the letter O. Please name both of them.
Mayo and Sligo.
Mayo and Sligo.
Correct. Secondly, what 3-letter word appears at the end of names of 2 neighbouring counties in the province of Leinster, south of Dublin?
3 letters.
Low.
Low is correct, yes. And finally, what 4-letter word ends the names of 2 counties that border County Kilkenny on Ireland's southeast coast?
Might be, is it Dare? Is it Dare? Kill Dare?
That's five. Do we have any others?
Ford, Waterford and Wexford.
Ford?
Waterford and Wexford is correct. Well done. 10 points for this. The Latin word stannum is the source of the chemical symbol of which element?
Glasgow Warburton.
Sorry, tin.
Tin is correct, yes. Right, these bonuses are on words derived from the Latin for to look. In each case, give the word from the definition. Firstly, an apparition, phantom or ghost, for example, in Philip Pullman's The Subtle Knife.
Like a sheed or something? Anything like that? I mean, do we know what the Latin for look is?
I did.
No. Do you know now? No. Do you want to just go like...
Ghoul? Ghoul?
Oh, Spectre. Spectre. Yeah, that's a good choice. Spectre?
Spectre is very good, yes. To engage in the buying and selling of commodities or effects in order to profit by a rise or fall in their market value.
Speculation?
Correct. And finally, a surgical instrument of various forms used for dilating a canal or orifice of the body so as to facilitate examination or an operation.
Nominate Warburton.
Speculum.
Speculum is correct, yes. We're going to take a picture round now. For your picture starter, you'll see a still from a film. Give me the title of the film, please.
Glasgow Greencorn.
Chicago.
It is Chicago, yes. The costumes in that movie are among the Oscar-winning work of designer Colleen Atwood. For your picture bonuses, I want you to identify three more films for which Atwood designed the costumes. Firstly...
That's very recognisable.
Is that Johnny Depp?
I think so. Does anyone have any idea what the movie's called? That's the question.
That would be important, but yeah. I got nothing.
I don't know. Dolly.
It's Ed Wood. Secondly.
Is that like Oprah in The Color Purple or something, maybe? I don't know.
So we're going to The Color Purple then. The Color Purple?
No, it's Beloved. And finally.
Oh, that's. Silence of the Lambs. That's Silence of the Lambs, yeah. Silence of the Lambs?
It is Silence of the Lambs, yes. 10 points for this. In musical performances, what French word describes the position of the mouth and lips when playing a wind instrument?
Glasgow Greencorn.
Embouchure.
Embouchure is correct, yes. Right, these bonuses are on the Woodhouse Prize for Comic Fiction. What language completes the title of Marina Levicka's 2005 winning novel, A Short History of Tractors in...
in... What language would that be?
Come on.
Yiddish.
No, it's Ukrainian. Secondly, the name of which Indian city on the River Ganges completes the title of Jeff Dyer's 2011 winning work, Jeff in Venice, Death in...
Varanasi probably would make sense. Varanasi?
Varanasi is correct. Which country completes the title of Paul Tordé's 2007 winning novel, Salmon Fishing in the...
Yemen.
Yemen is correct. 10 points for this. In Lewis Carroll's poem Jabberwocky, the hero is advised by his father to shun what creature described as frumious?
Exeter Parker.
The Bandersnatch.
The Bandersnatch is correct, yes. These bonuses are on medicine. The function of what internal organ of the human body is measured by testing blood levels of creatinine?
Maybe the spleen.
What makes you think that?
Because it's to do with blood.
Okay.
Really.
Spleen, pancreas, I was thinking.
Yeah, I'd go for it.
Spleen?
No, it's the kidney. Damage to what organ causes heightened levels in the blood of alanine, transaminase, or ALT?
Maybe that could be pancreas.
Pancreas.
Do you have any other ideas?
Yeah, go for it. Pancreas.
Pancreas?
No, it's liver. The health of what organ is measured by testing blood amylase levels?
Feel inclined to go for pancreas again.
Yeah, go for that again, I think.
Is that the pancreas?
That is the pancreas, yes. Right, 3 minutes to go, 10 points for this. The name of which country appears as the title of a work of 2018 by Max Hastings, subtitled... An
Exeter
epic...
Barker.
Vietnam.
Vietnam is correct, yes. You get 3 bonuses on Indonesia. The Sunda Strait separates which 2 Indonesian islands?
No, I think it's...
Come on.
Java and Sumatra.
Java and Sumatra.
Correct. Which strait separates Sumatra from the Malay Peninsula?
Malacca. Yeah,
Straits of Malacca. The Malacca Strait.
Correct. And finally, a little smaller than Great Britain, which island lies across the Makassar Strait from Borneo?
Sulawesi.
Sulawesi is correct. 10 points for this. What surname links all of the following? The painter in 1912 of Studland Beach, the MP for Tatton from 1997 to 2001, the voice of Princess Anna in the 2013 film Frozen.
Glasgow Nevitt.
Bell.
Bell is correct, yes. Right, these bonuses are on a vegetable. The culinary term ala du Barry and the Asian dish alu gobi both relate to which vegetable of the brassica family?
Brassica.
Come on, let's have it.
Cabbage.
That's the cauliflower. What short word is used for both the head of a cauliflower and often in the plural form a coagulated substance formed from milk?
Was that like curdle?
Curd.
Curd is correct. Named for its Italian origin and sometimes referred to as a broccoli. Which variety of cauliflower has a head made up of distinctive pale green florets arranged in a spiral pattern?
I don't like cauliflower.
I know Disney movies. I don't know broccoli.
We don't know. Sorry.
That's Romanesco. Right, 10 points for this. What activity appears in the titles of paintings by Cézanne and Seurat in the National Gallery in London? The scene of the latter work is the banks of the Seine at Anières.
Glasgow Nevis.
Bathing.
Bathing is correct, yes. Your bonuses are on screen versions of books by Daphne du Maurier. Which Oscar-winning British actress played the eponymous role in the 2017 adaptation of My Cousin Rachel?
I don't know. Oscar-winning British actress, anyone?
Come on, let's have
Olivia
it, please.
Coleman. Olivia Colman, yeah.
No, it's Rachel Weisz. Oh, yeah. Secondly, in which 1944 film set during the Restoration did Joan Fontaine... That was Frenchman's Creek. Exeter 145, you might come back as one of the highest scoring losing teams. We don't know, we'll see. And Glasgow, well done. 200 is a great score, and we should look forward to seeing you in the next stage of the competition for sure. Thank you very much. I hope you can join us next time for another first round match. But until then, it's goodbye from Exeter University.
Bye.
It's goodbye from Glasgow University.
Bye.
And it's goodbye from me. Goodbye.